Okay, good morning, YouTube. It's fucking Monday after holiday weekend. Look, Courtney, the cigarette's lit this time. I lit it before I started the video. I'm not condoning smoking, but let's do a kind of Surgeon General's warnings on these. I don't know. It must be. Oh, wait. Surgeon General's warning. Quitting smoking now greatly reduces serious risk to your health. Thank you, Surgeon General, for that bit of information. Don't smoke because it's bad, but, anyway, I'm really getting used to my hair. Sorry, look at when the sun hits that hair. It's fucking red. Red hair, strawberry blonde, whatever. I don't care what you want to call it. I'm in the redhead family. So, I'm getting used to the hair. 121 subscribers now. That's fucking awesome. Started off 118 when I was posting the videos. There's a police car, but here they usually just sit the empty fucking car. People just slow down. I think I was going to speed up anyway, so really hope this fucking construction up here doesn't take long to get through. My unnamed passenger that sometimes in here fixed the AC in my car. Thank God. Like, that was fucking ridiculous. Mostly because, well, he was hot. I was hot. It was motherfucking roast. And humidity was fucking ridiculous over the weekend. So, about murdered each other because we were both fucking hot and miserable. And then he put some Freon in my car. So, I'm very thankful for that. That's awesome. Thankful for my 121 subscribers. And all you people that didn't subscribe, I know some of you don't know how, or blah, 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 it's making an account, whatever, but, you know, it is what it is. I gotta think of something else fun to do here. Any suggestions? I know me and my daughter are gonna jump off that rock one of these days here soon, because I said when I get 150 subscribers, that's what we're gonna do, but, here's the construction. Yeah, I had no plan of getting a mohawk at 118, but worked out. Yeah, Crazy did a good job, I think. And I don't know, I might get someone to like trim the top, like that way if I want to spike it, I can spike it. But yeah, I had a nice 4th. I didn't see any fireworks, but we had a little cookout at my dad's. Couple people, the food was good and shit. I didn't drink because I got fucking plowed Friday night. You can't do it 2 days in a row. Drank the Ritas. Ooh, Ritas are my favorite. I love Ritas. They're 8% alcohol. The ones I make, now they're in a little 8-ounce can. They used to be 12-ounce. They had them before. It was a 24-ounce, but now they're 8-ounce, which, whatever, 8% alcohol. I fucking love them. The Pabst Blue Ribbon hard coffee, that's just really fucking good. Yeah, so we'll see what everyone has to say about my hair today. I really, I'm satisfied. I didn't think it was gonna go this well. I didn't think I was even gonna do it, actually. But maybe I'll start wearing earrings. I do want to get another tattoo. I want to get, even though I have no Native American in my blood, I do want to get, it's a turtle tattoo, and its legs are feathers. It's for the Turtle Clan, Shawnee. That's where I do have roots there, just no DNA, so whatever. Like I said, I'm still a Native American princess. I tell you I'm from Cousin Fucks County. And, like, it's seriously no fucking joke. And I know, like, generations ago, on my dad's side, like, I won't give you a last name or a county besides Cousin Fuck County, but, they were some of the, my dad's family were some of the first settlers there. And, oh, the light's green. Maybe I'll make it work today. I'd rather turn around, but whatever. So, what the fuck is my hair sticking like this? Okay, so my dad's family was some of the first settlers in Clear Cup County. And I guess, like, I don't know, first of all, there probably weren't a lot of people back then in that day. So, like, I don't know, you just marry your fucking cousin. And then another thing would be like, well, who do you trust more with your daughter than your fucking nephew across the road? Take care of my daughter like she's your own fucking family. Oh, wait, she is. You know, it is what it is. But anyway, so it'd be,
38 special.
My
name is Rondo. Well,
my dad's grandfather.
Given to,
no.
Michelle Heritage.
My dad's great grandfather.
32nd birthday.
My great great grandfather.
31.
His parents both have the same last name. Definitely related. They were like, I don't know, maybe like second cousins. And then her parents, they were, so William, he came from Jacob and Sarah. And Jacob and Sarah were like probably second cousins. And this was back in whatever, like I said, William was my great great grandfather on my dad's side. So you had his parents and they're like second cousins. And then you go up one, Sarah's parents. They're like first cousins once removed. So then, of course, like they both have the same last name. So, they come over here from Switzerland. I always thought it was a German name, but it's actually from Switzerland. So, I'm a Swiss. And the blood stayed strong down the line because there was so much inbreeding. It's like you get 50% from your mom and 50% from your dad. But if you're just passing on the same fucking DNA for generation after generation, this is what happens. Like, oh, those motherfuckers used to be like upstanding fucking citizens of Cousin Puck County and shit until the inbreeding started, and then we just started having less and less. I don't know. I don't want to call them morals, but like, a law? What the fuck is that? So, you know, it is what it is, but I think that's what happened. Every fucking generation of inbreeding just took some of that give a fuck away from us, but I'm fine with who I am. I'm glad they stopped, like, where they did, because it would have probably started getting fucking serious. Like, oh, I think I got a little mustache now. Motherfucker would have probably been real bad. But yeah, so, definitely in the generations up there, I have a lot of, like, you know, the last name, you wouldn't think I'd. But so when my DNA came, I did have the relatives on my dad's side, like they're further away, but I have more DNA than I should because we just, like, my one grandpa, he was my grandpa like two or three times from going up the line because they were all from the same family. They came over, a couple brothers from Switzerland. But so that's an interesting fact. Like, I can genuinely tell you I am from Cousin Puck County. That is no fucking lie, which I'm not a liar, I'm an asshole, and sometimes I bitch at the one guy for being mean and too honest, but I mean, I can be a little bit like that myself, but I'm better at it, because a lot of people don't know if I'm joking or not. But yeah, so that, definitely a lot of inbreeding out there, and then I'm like, so they came over from Switzerland and then we're all still there, so probably related to half the fucking town, but you know, that's what you get for not leaving. And then the one guy, his name was Henry, he's my grandpa a couple times, so like, I guess you take some of the numbers away, something, I don't know. Ancestry doesn't explain that. I'm like, oh, okay, why the fuck don't you? I got some other, like, oh, my tree, it's not even a tree on that side, it's like a grapevine, but I gotta double check with all the family before I out all our shit on freaking YouTube, because, you know, I've already had some interesting facts that I'm not saying on my dad's side or whatever, but, like, one of my family members was too pussy to, you know, because it's obviously going to incriminate them when I tell you some of my shit, but whatever. I don't call it a family tree. I call it a grapevine. But that's One time before I started researching my family tree, I was bartending and these guys come in. They're like, they were from the city. I think they were like on a hunting trip or something, whatever. So they're like, oh, they're having a good time. I'm entertaining. I bartend on the side, but I don't mind it. I'm not doing it right now. But, and with the shutdown and shit, who the fuck wants to go to the bar? Can't get motherfucking drunk to listen to regular rules. Everybody, social distance. Yeah, okay. Like, that's gonna happen. Oh, what's going on here? Got a roll back. Okay, so yeah, these guys were like, the bartenders are like you back home. Like, oh, you want to know my secret? Yeah. So I'm whispering and getting close. But all I know, I was fucking spewing the honest truth to those guys. But yeah, Cousin Fuck County, that's where it's at. Yeah, so how good we really am from Cousin Fuck County. Oh, my shirt today, it says upper class white trash. It used to say trailer trash, because it's like camping. But I thought that was funnier. So I had a girl make it. Love the shirt anyway, from Crazy Creation. She does a really good job and she's very reasonably priced. But yeah, I am top of the scale poverty. Like, that's whatever. I'm afraid if I hit middle class and start getting normal and shit. I don't want to be normal. So I am perfectly fine with high class poverty. So, you know, I don't want to get too fucking stinky-pooty. And that's at one income. So, I'm pretty proud of myself. No college education. Had my job for going on 11 years this year. So, I'm satisfied with where I came in life. First kid at 19. Second one right after that. No college education. I have no complaints about where I've come in life, because money is not everything. Money is the root of all evil, and I wish we could live in bartering days. And I don't know, I kind of don't, because, like, back in the bartering days, I don't know, I could have probably rocked the free spinstress paddle in our own canoe, but if me and Jess were old biddies living together, we'd have to say we were sisters. They'd either, we'd get burned at the cross. They'd think we were witches or lesbians or something that wasn't acceptable back in those days, you know. But we could say we were sisters because, like, well, what are you going to, you know, DNA, motherfuckers? Times ain't evolved. So I definitely think we could do it. It'd just be, you know, out in the middle of the woods by yourself. In the bartering days, I would have fucking loved that. I'd have to get used to fucking killing animals. But for, I mean, I could do it for food. I would give thanks, and I'm thankful for me to have, but don't want to kill it. Anyway, you know what? Have a good week, motherfuckers. I'll be back. Show off my hair a little bit more. Thank you, crazy. But yeah, fuck community standards. Fuck switching lanes and shit. That's hate it. But I'm almost starting my fucking Monday out, so fuck community standards, Giant Eagle, Wendy's, people that want to prosecute people for, like, just, I don't know, calm the fuck down these days, people, like, that poor guy. No, I'm not saying this poor guy, he probably was a dickhead, but he didn't hurt the cat, okay? He was nice to the cat, he fucking... Nobody has any proof that he was mean to the cat. This is America. We are innocent. Don't prove it guilty. So fuck all the bullshit. Bye.